Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today, let's upgrade iCloud storage. Let's rock and roll. You've probably all been there in one way, shape, or form. Your iCloud storage got full, and you got to make a decision. Either you deal with the annoying messages and prompts and notifications that pop up on your devices, you either get rid of iCloud completely or you upgrade your iCloud storage. Today, we're gonna upgrade my iCloud storage. Now, depending on what devices you have, you can either update from your computer or your iPhone or your iPad. iPhone and iPad are pretty much the same, but I'm gonna show you both the computer and the iPad. So let's go on my computer here. I'm gonna open up System Preferences, and across the top I have where it has my account for the Apple ID and iCloud. I'm gonna go to Apple ID, and again, choose iCloud on the left, and down here at the bottom, we can see my iCloud storage is full. 5 gigabytes, 0 available, and I'm gonna choose Manage. And this is where I can choose either to stop using some of the services, so I could turn off and delete the photos, but in return, it's not gonna synchronize to any of my devices anymore or be backed up. So that's why I want to use iCloud. So I'm gonna choose Buy More Storage in the top right. And when I do that, I have the 3 different plans here. I can choose the 50 gigabyte, 200, or 2 terabyte. The 200 gigabyte and the 2 terabyte you can actually use with family members, which is really, really nice. I encourage you to do that, especially if you have, well, honestly, if you have more than one person in your house, it's a no-brainer. For $1 a month for 50 gigs instead of $1.50 split between 2 people to double that storage or to quadruple that storage, it's a no-brainer. So recommend doing that. Now, these plans are only for upgrading the iCloud. Apple came out actually with a whole new service. Pull up Apple's website, and their whole service is bundling all of their services essentially. So a lot of people have kind of gotten into the ecosystems, and you know, the Apple Music, the Apple Arcade, Apple TV, iCloud is a huge one, Apple News and Apple Fitness. So Apple kind of took those other plans from just iCloud being your storage and your backup and your photo syncing and your messages and all of those different things that iCloud does, and they're tying it into this kind of one overall membership. So here's the prices for that. $15, which gets you 50 gigs, but you get their music subscription, which is I think $10 or $15 a month. So if you use Spotify or Pandora, something like that, you have the potential to say, okay, get rid of that music streaming, go with Apple Music, and then you also get their Apple TV subscription, their arcade subscription, and iCloud storage. And so here they have a family plan, $20 a month, 200 gigs, and then their premier one, which bumps you up to 2 terabytes, and you get everything included. $30 a month, yes, it seems pricey at first, but when you break it down and consider what it is, like for me currently, I pay $10 a month for iCloud storage, but I also pay $15 a month for Spotify, and I pay $15 a month for Netflix and all of these other services. So I can actually eliminate some of those, consolidate, and go with this, because then I can get my news from here. I can get rid of Spotify and use Apple Music if I wanted to, because I'm already tied into the ecosystem with all of my photos and all of my videos and my text messages and all of that. And all of my kids and my wife use it as well, because they all have iPhones or iPads and they're backing up and using the iCloud storage too. And what's really cool about this plan is with the Apple One, you can actually bump it up to 4 terabytes. So if you're at that point where you do use this a lot, especially for photos or videos or just iCloud Drive in general, if you sign up for Apple One subscription, you have the ability to bump it up to the 4 terabyte option. But I get on tangents. It happens. So let's go back to just the pure basic iCloud storage. So here I could select 50 gigs and do 99 cents a month and do next. And then it's going to prompt me to put in my password and my credit card and all of that. Now let's do the same process and finish it through on the iPad. They're going to be very, 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 very similar. And everything on the iPad is going to be identical if you have an iPhone as well. I just do it because it's a bigger screen. So we're going to go to settings here. I'm going to touch my account in the top left. I'm going to choose iCloud on the far right. We're going to go to manage storage, And then we're going to say upgrade to sync my stuff. I don't need the 2 terabyte. Let's go with the 200 gigabyte because in more videos that are coming up, I'm going to start doing family sharing, child accounts, and all that good stuff. So let's go ahead and choose buy. So you can cancel at any time. It's showing me it's going to be $2.99 a month. And I'm going to use my fingerprint here to process the payment. I don't have a payment on file, and that's what it's saying. It's saying, hey, can't buy it if you don't have any credit card on file. So I'm going to choose continue. And this is where you're going to type in your card information. So touch and hold, manage payments. I don't need another Apple credit card. So we're going to do add payment method. We're going to do credit and debit card. And this is, and you have a couple different options of how you want to pay for it. You could do their Apple credit card, which is really, really nice, actually. You can type in your own credit and debit card, or you can pay with PayPal. So I'm going to do a number here. All right. So now I have my number in there, credit card, first name, last name, address. I'm going to touch done in the top right, and it's going to add this payment and associate this credit card to this Apple ID on file. And then it takes a moment for it to go through. And now notice 5 gigabytes out of 200 gigs available. Now it says share with family. And then I can also change the storage plan. So if I touch change storage plan, I can always go back and go up to the 2 terabyte, or I can touch downgrade options. And I can always go back to the 50 gigabyte if I wanted to, or just go to the free one. But I'm going to touch cancel here because I'm not going to do that. And then this other option is share with family. And if I touch that, it's going to bring me to the family sharing for iCloud. And that's where I invite members or I create a child account. Now that I've done this and upgraded the storage, I can go through and I can go back to iCloud backup where here the last message, the iPad cannot be backed up because it's not enough iCloud storage available. So now I can actually touch backup now and fully back this up. This will work behind the scenes. I'm gonna exit out of the settings. Let's jump back to the computer here. Let's kind of refresh the system preferences. I'm gonna go to manage. And notice it changed now once I kind of refreshed it. So now I have 200 gigs here, 193 available. So I'm going to choose done. Now I have all of this space. And if I open up photos on here, on the Mac, and scroll down towards the bottom, it's going to start updating and uploading all of these as well. So then now I'm able to take pictures on my phone again and have it go to my Mac and to my iPad, and all of my devices are going to be on the same page. I can jump out to iCloud.com here. So let's go to iCloud. We'll sign in and I should be able to go to account settings, and I can see the storage available here as well. So I can say, yep, I have 200 gigs available. So now all of this stuff can be uploaded into the cloud. If I go to settings, go to photos, it's going to start synchronizing any photos that were on my other devices. You kind of get the point. I was full on my iCloud. I filled up the 5 useless gigs that Apple gives you. Can you tell I'm a little bit bitter about that? But I upgraded to 200 gigs, so now I have plenty of room. I know that if I go back into the settings, my iCloud backup, that is going to finish. And it can take a while because it hasn't backed up in a long time. And we have to keep in mind that if I go back to general and go back to iPad storage, it's backing up a lot of this stuff. It's backing up text messages, your photos, your notes, your email, all of the settings on your iPad, all of the layouts, all of the apps. So it can take a while if it hasn't done it. So that's kind of the process of updating. That's why you would want to update your iCloud. Now, let's just say that I had a ton of photos on my computer and I wanted to start using iCloud for my photographs, and I only upgraded to the 50 gigabyte. So if I had 100 gigabytes worth of photographs, that 50 gigabytes is not going to be enough. So accommodate, you know, plan ahead of what storage you might think you need based off of what the features of iCloud you actually want to use on your devices. Most people use photos and videos, so that's why I kind of use that as the primary example. But yeah, that is how you update your iCloud storage. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something. If you did, hit that subscribe button, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.